call to order, and we have an oath and a song.
I, Diane Martinez, solemnly pledge that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California as I discharge my duties as a city council member for the city of Emeryville. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me.
Right. Do I have a motion to approve?
Move to approve the agenda.
Second.
Oh, would I be able to call the roll real quick?
Oh, excuse me.
Only if it's real quick.
Councilmember Martinez?
Here.
Councilmember Medina?
Aye.
Councilmember Pat?
Here.
Vice Mayor Bowders?
Here.
And Mayor Donahue?
Here.
Move to approve the agenda.
Second.
Moved by Vice Mayor Bowders, seconded by Councilmember Martinez. Councilmember Martinez?
Aye.
Councilmember Medina?
Aye.
Councilmember Pats?
Aye.
Vice Mayor Bowders?
Aye.
And Mayor Donahue?
Aye. Public comment to items not on the agenda.
Or?
Ex parte, we have to approve the agenda for tonight.
You did that.
We did that, okay, but that is, let me just make sure that, okay, you're right. And then ex parte communications.
Mr. Mayor, I have met with representatives from Mills College, with representatives from ACE, from eBase, from Center of Popular Democracy, and one Emeryville worker.
I have also met with representatives from Mills College and had a conference call with representatives from ACE and CPD.
I had a conference call with members of ACE, and I met with, and on the call was a member from the Center for Popular Democracy and Jenny Lynn. Action items. Update on Fair Work Week implementation.
April Shabazz will provide you with a recap of the update that was provided at your previous meeting.
Feel free to make it short, April.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good evening, council members and Mayor Donahue. I won't put up the slides because it would be just repeating. I'll just briefly overview the memo that you all have. And as you're aware, at the last council meeting, there was a decision made to form a subcommittee with Councilmember Martinez and Medina to meet with Mills College, the proposed contractor. And we did meet on April 25th here at City Hall. And in that meeting, we had a discussion about the importance of including all stakeholders in this process. In that meeting, I explained, as a part of the RFP process, it was a requirement for bidders to give us a strategic plan on how they would include not just employers, but employees, advocacy groups, business associations, and anyone else who would be considered a stakeholder in this process. At that meeting, Mills communicated to us what their plans were to engage all parties, and I think we were all in agreement that it sounded well balanced and they had a very impartial approach in their plan. And the information gathered from the meetings that they will conduct with all stakeholders will then be translated into educational marketing materials, and then that information will feed the regulations process by which the attorney that we'll hire will formulate. So there were no changes made to their contract at the time of that meeting, so we're just proposing that we move forward and getting it underway, because I'm getting lots of calls. Not complaints, but just calls of businesses wanting to understand what's going on and understand what the regulations will be. So that's all I have.
Clarifying questions.
Any questions?
Just one. The contract is for April 20th of this year through June 30th of next year. And do we anticipate this is a contract that would need to be renewed annually for any reason?
The plan was for it to be renewed up to two times, I believe. So we're a little bit off schedule, so it probably would be a contract from May to June, and then we'll revisit everything and then come back with another if everything goes well.
Or so do we need to amend the exhibit that says April 20th?
I think.
Yeah, I mean, we can change the start date to be sort of the effective date of the council's approval, for example.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's okay.
Any other questions?
Public comment. We have Leah Mowering.
Actually, Kate.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I lost my voice today. I lectured earlier today. I represent Mills College, and thank you to council members Medina and Martinez for meeting with us. I think we had a very productive meeting.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you.
Is this better?
Yes. Yeah,
thank you. Thank you for your patience. So we had a very productive meeting where we kind of reiterated our commitment to being an impartial party in education of the city of Emeryville on this particular topic. It's not like we're not open to working with all different advocacy groups, but we're going to take every single group as the valid stakeholder in this process. And I think it's important to have a party like us who's going to treat everyone on an equal footing and incorporate all this information into education. So our goal here is not to take sides, but to educate and to report back to the city attorney, to all the stakeholders, to you guys. We're looking forward to working closely with the city. So that's all I had to say.
Thank you. Anya.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay, we're going to let her have Kelby's time.
So how much time do I have?
You
six
have
minutes.
6 minutes.
All right. Okay, well, I've got lots of notes, so I'll just hit each point. So I think most of you know me and have met me a number of times. I haven't met you. I met you once before you were elected. So nice to meet you. So I'm an organizer at ACE. I've been organizing in Emeryville, the retail workers, for the past 2+ years was a really critical part of having this policy passed. And really our interest here is just to make sure that the spirit of the policy to actually fundamentally change the outcome of workers' lives is seen through. And that in any enforcement or implementation strategy that does not include as much worker outreach as there is to employers is actually not impartial and is not neutral. From the proposal that we're seeing being put forward that is being considered right now, it seems that there are only, I have the actual number, let me just pull it up right now. There are two trainings proposed for employees in July. So that's July, that's after the implementation date, and that's the only trainings that we're seeing. And that to me does not seem sufficient or impartial or neutral. This is a complaint-based policy. And so if the workers themselves are not informed of their rights and don't know how to complain about it or where to go, there will be no complaints. And therefore it looks great, but doesn't necessarily mean that anyone's lives are being changed. The city is investing $182,000 with most of that money going to businesses and very few of that going to workers. And so I think
it just begs the question of, like, what are the city's priorities with this policy? Workers are part of the fabric that makes Emeryville an economic success. In order for this policy to be successful in fulfilling the promise the city made to retail workers, outreach needs to be a core part of this. There are 4,000 retail workers in Emeryville, so I as an organizer, I think, how are you going to make sure that all of those workers are informed? Two trainings is not going to cut it. How are they going to make sure, how are they going to inform people about what the, where those trainings are, when those trainings are? If only five people come to both trainings, is that considered sufficient? And then what happens to the city when complaints come flooding in starting, you know, a week after July about people not getting predictability pay, about people not getting access to hours? Will that have been money well spent? So I guess just, you know, our perspective is that the contract, whoever it goes to, needs to include far more worker outreach than what is currently being outlined and what we see. And that, you know, the country is really looking at Emeryville right now to see how well this policy is going to be implemented. You know, this is the third in the nation, the strongest in the nation. There's a lot of talk about retail right now, and so people are watching this. And if this doesn't work, I think that it reflects poorly on the city. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I made most of my points, but I would just beg that the contract as is, with as minimal amount of worker outreach, is not approved, and that there is more included in order for it to be considered sufficient for the city. So I think that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any other speakers? Okay, I have some anecdotal testing I've been doing of retail workers. I bought a new cell phone, got a new cell phone contract, two different stores. I shop at Home Depot all the time. None of the workers have any idea about our Fair Work Week ordinance in my anecdotal testing out there. I think that this is an issue, you know, just that, yeah, I'm not a definitive test, but the retail workers that I've run into have no idea and that this is coming, but maybe I'm going, have any of you?
Well, Mr. Mayor, this might be a good question for staff. If April's getting phone calls upon phone calls, are you getting any from workers? None. No, she's only getting calls from businesses.
Well, this is what the contract's for. We haven't had anyone. We haven't had anyone doing outreach yet, so this is what the contract is in fact for. So, hopefully, I think the point of this is to try to remediate that problem.
So, Mr. Mayor, if I may, I just want to thank everyone who came out to speak tonight, everyone who's in attendance, and I want to thank Mills College for taking the time to sit down with myself and Councilmember Medina. I think we're a lot more comfortable with the process now that we have some clarity on how you're going to move forward. And for the public, I do want to highlight that we did receive a letter. It was sent by Jennifer Lynn at eBase, and it's in reference to incorporating ACE and CPD into the process of implementation and outreach. But, you know, respectfully, they're requesting that we consider this resolution. At this time, however, I think it's really important that we move forward with the Mills contract, because as you've heard from staff, we're hearing from a lot of businesses, and those are gonna be the folks who are gonna have to bear the brunt of the work to actually implement this policy. And certainly I have an interest in making sure that workers are well informed. And in the interest of that, I would like to make a motion that we approve the Mills contract And included in that motion, I propose that we take up this resolution at a later date so we can fully process it and have a good public conversation about what's proposed in this resolution that was emailed to us today.
I would just like to say that I perceive Mills as having the freedom to hire expertise that you see available to you. If you would like to hire the Center for Popular Democracy or the advocacy groups that really are in touch with workers, if you see utility in this, I don't see anything in our contract that would prevent you from consulting, hiring any of the groups that may help you in your cause. Yes.
We would really rely on this group and other groups as a part of, you know, our initial information collection. And by the way, when it comes the time to work with the outreach to the retail workers, these are the critical players that are in this room that we'll need to collaborate with. However, as an educational institution, we're not really at liberty to hire an advocacy group to do the education on our behalf. So there could be some technical hurdles to us having the formal arrangement. I guess nothing prevents you from working with the advocacy group, but as an educational institution, there could be some hurdles. And it's nothing personal, and I would love to work.
Can you speak to the microphone so we can hear you? Thank you.
It's nothing personal. I have, you know, very deep respect for this group, and we will not succeed in educating the retail workers without this group. So while they're the key partner and key player in this relationship, it's just for us formalizing this arrangement through hire or subcontract might not be feasible. So it's just in your decision-making process, I wanted you to be aware of this fact.
Thanks. Taking this up as a resolution really falls outside of the RFP process for this. So I'm wondering how you feel that would work within that.
Well, I think we could have that discussion. I'm not comfortable discussing this what was sent to us today. I do want to have an open public discussion about it, and so I think we should bring it forward as an agenda item. And whether we move forward with this as a resolution or we take a separate course of action, I think we can talk about it at that time, but I'm not comfortable discussing it exactly because it's, you know, my fear for not having enough transparency is that bringing this up today at a meeting that's a special meeting on, not a regular meeting, mm-hmm. I think it's not really adequate public notice for folks.
I agree. So I then second your motion to approve the Mills contract and move forward with this.
I have concerns about the process a little bit now because I think there's a couple things. One, there's a fiscal consideration that we need to make. This is a contract that I've heard may be renewed for a couple years. We have a budget gap to address, and so the predictability of what we're going to do is important to me. And on the other item is that I've heard a couple things. I've heard advocates say that they don't feel Mills would be impartial. And so I'm a little concerned at this point about creating a contract that does not incorporate in one place everybody who's got to get along and work on this. My initial reaction was that we have a contract for 1 year for Mills that may be renewable, and that we work on maybe improving our partnership in the ways that I've heard Mills express their interest in doing. And if there's a need to come back to this in a year to make changes to that, we could do that at that time. I'm hearing a motion to continue investigating the alternatives that were proposed, and I don't want to provide a substitute motion to what Councilmember Martinez has asked, unless others feel that that would be a better approach at this time.
I'm sorry, do you want to offer to, what are you suggesting?
My motion would be to approve the Mills contract without any additional conditions on that.
Without looking at this resolution, without discussing this again.
Without discussing this, because at this point, what I'm hearing is that we would potentially be making another expenditure in the coming fiscal year for this. And so we have, and am I correct, staff, that we have the question I have is, do we have enforcement contract to review too, right? So my concern is just, what is the expanse of this now? Because the presentation I think we received captured some things, and so this isn't included in the 182. So I just want to be clear.
Correct. And this is the reason why I don't feel like this is the appropriate conversation for this resolution is it's kind of a hybrid between implementation and enforcement. So the scope could be seen outside of what Mills is doing.
Okay.
I think it's a perfectly reasonable thing. If you're feeling comfortable with the Mills contract, you're not feeling comfortable.
Am I uncomfortable? Yeah.
Yes.
No, I'm comfortable with the Mills contract. It's like doing a separate issue again now.
I think that what I'm hearing Member Martinez and Member Medina say is they just want to agendize it so we can have that conversation. We're not saying we're going to approve it in the future, but simply have the conversation. And I respect Member Martinez for saying, look, we're not even going to consider this tonight because we haven't had time. And the community hasn't had time. And so for that reason.
Not to mention staff.
I'm sorry, I apologize. I did not mean to forget you. And for that reason, it amounts to the same, whether we separate them and make it a separate motion or do it all in one fell swoop. The idea of agendizing something in the future is always, something that I'm comfortable with to have a conversation.
I'm generally not. I want to be really clear. I'm not opposed to talking about anything. My concern is that what I've heard from staff and advocates the entire time is we need to have these contracts executed, and we're already behind the game on actually ramping up and having this ready to go. And I heard people say tonight that the trainings are even going to be later than when the law takes effect. And so my fear is, like, we're going to what does it look like? We just put this resolution as an agenda item? Is that what you're asking for, to consider this actual proposal?
That's what I'm asking, yes.
Okay, all right, because I was going to say staff having to, like, prepare something to do this and, like, when would it fit into this time frame? It concerns me about we're not actually going to get this off the ground in time.
I don't think that any of the work that Mills is doing should be delayed in any sense.
Okay.
And that's why I think their contract should be approved.
I'm ready to vote on the motion.
Should we get clarification?
Yeah. So if I can repeat the motion and second that I think is on the floor, and if council can confirm that. So what we have is a motion by Councilmember Martinez and seconded by Councilmember Medina to approve the Mills contract and then to review the proposal that was presented by ACE and eBase today. At a future council meeting.
Correct.
So essentially we're approving the resolution that was in the packet,
right.
And we're bringing back a future agenda item.
Correct. Yes. I'd like to make a friendly amendment to the motion, which is that the contract will be amended to say April 27th.
I'll accept that.
All right, with all of that in effect, I'll take the vote. Councilmember Martinez?
Aye.
Councilmember Medina?
Aye.
Councilmember Patz?
Aye.
Vice Mayor Bowders?
Aye.
And Mayor Donahue?
Aye.
So, really quickly, I just want to say I'm excited that we were able to get Mills College in here. I'm always excited when we get one of the traditional colleges, be it a traditional women's college or a traditional black college, to come in and do the research. As somebody who loves academia, there's not enough women represented in the higher levels, and so I'm always excited that we can do that, so thank you.
And Mr. Mayor, if I may, I just want to thank those folks who are here to represent workers, because I think our goal is to absolutely execute the spirit of the law as it was, as we signed it into law.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I concur with that. We really, this is about helping retail workers' lives. And let's not forget, that's what we're doing here.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we are going to adjourn to a closed session meeting.
We have another open session meeting.
Oh, that's going to, he's got a note.
So we close this meeting and then open another one, right?
Are we we're having that meeting somewhere else, is that correct?
Have a note on your
agenda. Yes, we're meeting.
You have a note.
It's on your agenda.
Where's the other?
That's correct.
Second floor.
Over there.
Conference room. Second floor council.
Okay. Across the way.
So we're going to adjourn in this location, reconvene at the next special meeting, second floor conference room at City Hall.
Essentially take a break, right?